Hey everyone, welcome back to the Fun Indian Guy podcast, episode number 8. Awesomeness. I just love keep making these episodes. Anyway, as you must have read the title of the today's episode already, we are doing one experiment in today's episode. In today's episode, I'm going to use background music or background score to make this podcast super interesting. For example, now I'm going to explain you why we are talking about today's topic of what startups are missing on or what startups and entrepreneurs need to know if they don't know about it, because it's just unfortunate if people don't know about it. But if they know about this, it's gonna make a lot of difference in your business, in your startup, in your entrepreneurship, or whatever you are trying to do in the sector of business or any upcoming technologies or innovations. So let's start this narration, this story, with that amazing cinematic background score. Let's go. So on Friday, last Friday evening, I finished my work and I was going to this amazing startup event called Berlin Startup Night 2018. This event was organized by Deutsche Telekom. The company which I'm working for is a telecommunication company, partnered with other brands like Volkswagen, Microsoft, and I guess Deutsche Bank. And it was an amazing, interesting event as far as I saw it on internet. So I went there. I went first of all to the Volkswagen area called Drive, where there were a lot of startups incubated there. So basically this whole event was about startups. There were small booths where these startups were there, explaining what they're working on, making contacts with possible investors. And these startups were incubated or accelerated by Telekom, like Deutsche Telekom or Volkswagen, for that matter, where I was. So I initially visited Volkswagen because, wait a minute, I need to give a shout out to my friends, because I have this friend called Ben. You have seen him in one of the vlogs I made at Dusseldorf back in the day, I guess in the May 2018, when I was vlogging in Dusseldorf. If you watch my vlogs, he used to work for Volkswagen, so he also had some friends at Volkswagen, and Volkswagen was one of the partners, as I said, in this event. So thank you, Max, who introduced me to this event, and because of him, I was there. And thank you so much, Max, and his friend. I really forgot his name, which is super unfortunate. I'm really sorry. I will message Max to ask your name. I'm really sorry. I'm not proud of this moment. Anyway, thank you, both of you guys, and also Ben, for letting me know about this event. And it was really wonderful. I had a lot of value out of it. Thank you so much. Back to the cinematic background. So I went to this event. I was going around, I was walking around, I was looking through all these startups, amazing startups, enthusiastic people explaining how they are working on the startups and what is their vision and what they are going to do about it. Also went through a lot of talks, a lot of discussions by a lot of people, especially in telecom. It was about AI, blockchain, machine learning, and some sorts of talks in that direction. At the same time, at Volkswagen, I got to listen to talks by innovation lab heads of Audi Innovation Lab, Volkswagen Innovation Lab, and Porsche Digital Lab. It was really interesting to know what these people are talking about when it comes to innovation. I also met my friends I worked with back in the day when I used to work at Porsche Consulting, and it was really fun to catch up with them. Okay, back to the story. So one thing I realized after going through this whole experience of Startup Night, I talked to all these people. I talked to many people who were working at the startup. I talked to also the people who work at the incubators and the accelerators who support these startups. There was lack of one major thing. And it's very personal for me, because this is what we are studying, okay? This is what my professional thing is. So the thing is, okay, let's stop that music. So the thing is, when I was at the startup, maybe let's put some action background so you get the depth of the conversation. So at the event, I was there. I was walking towards people. I was talking to people. I was meeting these people. As I said before, I started the conversation. Hey, I'm Suyo, also known as the Fun Indian Guy. I'm a designer. What is your startup about? Then they talked about the whole startup. And then they asked me, what kind of designer are you? My answer, I'm a service designer. Their question, what is service design? Is it like UX or UI? Design, or that's what you do. For the people who don't know these terminologies, UX design is basically user experience design. So here you consider the experience of user and design accordingly, word to word explanation about the term. And the other thing is user interface design. So basically, whenever you take your phone in your hand or any digital device or any also physical devices, the thing you see is user interface. The interface where you are able to do stuff or you are able to see stuff is user interface. So there are designers who design these user interfaces, and there are designers who also design the experiences they get out of it. So there are that. So that's why the term UX UI. So the people started to ask me, are you a UX UI designer? I was like, see, I'm a service designer primarily, but I do UX UI design. Now the main missing link is here, and why I feel very unfortunate to explain these to people again and again, and why there needs to be awareness out there about service design, and why people need to know, because it's for people's benefit. If they know service design or if they know a service designer, it will help their business or it will help their any sort of projects they are doing, because service design is an amazing field where we do stuff considering all the people, all the stakeholders which are related to service, be it physical or digital, and do co-creational processes or do very various mappings and then come up with solutions. And then we design innovative ideas for projects or for brands or for anything. And why this is important, and how, if you are a startup or if you are an entrepreneur, if you are an entrepreneur, how it's going to help you, we're going to discuss that. But after this intro, let's go. Hi, I'm Suyog, also known as the Fun Indian Guy. I'm a designer, musician, filmmaker, and a mechanical engineer. I'm from India, and currently I'm chilling around, traveling around, working around, roaming around, having fun around Europe, and this is my podcast. The Fun Indian Guy Podcast. Thank you so much, Anuj, for making that amazing intro. By the way, we also have intro for the videos now. If you haven't seen my last vlog, the vlog was about 5 things which make me love coffee. In that vlog, I have dropped the brand new, super hot, just out of the oven intro of the Fun Indian Guy. So go check out that video. If you are watching it on YouTube, you will have the suggestion on this corner, and you can just hit it and then see the amazing intro we have made for the Fun Indian Guy videos. Not the podcast, the other videos. Anyway. So we were talking about service design and why it is important. The basic approach or the usual approach when it comes to startups is basically developers. I saw a lot of developers. I did not meet a single designer in that whole event apart from my friend Parth, who was with me. So most of the people, or almost all of the people I met, were either designers or something related to business management. And which is good, because these people are needed when it comes to startup. But the missing link is designer, and not only UX UI designer, but service designer. And also a quick fact, I am going to drop amazing videos about how we can implement service design, or what is service design, and how we can innovate, and all those sorts of videos on the series called Innovation 101, which is on my channel. Already one video is there, how to win hackathons without coding. So it's worth checking out. Link just above if you're watching the YouTube video of this podcast. So these startups are consisted of developers and the business management people, and all those people except designers. And what happens in this situation is usually developers are coming up with the solutions, okay? And generally these are codes and the things which they are developing in on their computer, and coming up with these amazing technologies back to back, like some developments in blockchain or some developments in AI. But they are best in making things. They are best in solving how to make things. They are best in explaining or defining how to make some sort of a product or a service or a system. But a clear observation I had after this event was missing link related to why. Why did you design that, or why did you make that, first of all, is the missing link. Because this why part is usually not explored much. You can do things, but why you do things, for what purpose, for what reason, is very important. So in service design, we take all the services, and basically in the ideation period, or basically the foundation of any service or project, we think about why to do stuff. And that time the human-centered approach come in the picture. So if somebody is facing some problems in their life, or if some sort of user is facing some sort of exact problem in some context in their life, how we should resolve that, what are the steps we should follow in order to make his life better. That's the simplest explanation about service design. And there are many various topics which I'll be discussing in upcoming videos. But service designers are trained to follow methodologies in order to ideate or in order to come up with why before how. And that is very important. But at the same time, if you are a developer or if you are a entrepreneur in a startup and you already have some sort of idea you wanted to work on and you did not figure out the why part but you knew the how part, still you are in position to apply why part now, so you know that if your service is still makes sense or needs some tweaking, because why part will always guide you towards what changes you are supposed to make or you should make in your service in order to make it more appealing or more useful, or it should make life easier and not just something related to marketing or making money. I felt super bad regarding this topic because we were in Berlin in startup night. Berlin is one of the hot destinations for startups right now in Europe. And nobody knew about service design. And the fact that service design originated in Cologne, which is also in Germany, and it was also 10 to 20 years ago. And there is no awareness around service design. And when I studied service design, when I started to apply, when I did projects and workshops with companies, I could feel the importance and I could feel the power of service design or design thinking in general when it comes to innovation or when it comes to projects. But it's very disappointing to understand that very few people know about it and there is no clear approach towards spreading it or to make everybody realize how it can change the innovation or redesigning process. And that's why I am going to make more videos about this. And that's why I'm gonna have this series Innovation 101, which is already rolling on my channel. And I'm gonna talk more about all this service design, design thinking, design methods, quick ways to innovate, or some, I'm gonna take up also challenges from you guys where I'm gonna innovate in 24 hours. Not like I'm gonna innovate, but I'm gonna follow some methods in order to come up with really good solutions or insights which could be taken to further processes. But I'm gonna do all that and show you how to do it. Chances are I might as well fail, but doing is very important when it comes to trying something. And I really want everybody to understand the importance of this field. I really want everybody to understand what this field is about. And as we have been already breaking down the cliches of designers who make things beautiful to graphic designers, product designers, industrial designers, or UX UI designers, but all these upcoming fields or all these new fields which are very meaningful, for example, design thinking has proven it's important for a long time now, service design and all these things are there, are around there, are available, are free. People, I'm not talking about me, but people like me are in position to practice them or are in position to apply them in real life solutions or in real life problems or in real life challenges for any brand or startup or entrepreneur or any other sorts of problem, be it social problems or anything, because there is also a huge or big field of social innovation. All these things need to be spread around, need to be talked about, and then only we will be able to get it out there and start working on it. So one of the challenges or one of the missions of the Fun Indian Guy channel is also going to be about spreading awareness regarding design, innovation, service design, design thinking, or anything, so that you can benefit something out of it and we make this place a better place. This is like a standard designer phrase, like, let's make this world a better place to live in. Let's not go super philosophical about it. This podcast was just to express myself about what I felt when I went through startups, how the awareness regarding service design or how the awareness about design thinking is needed and will make life of startups and entrepreneurs way better and way different. And for that, I'm trying to get in touch with a lot of people and do some workshops or at least do simple talks or discussions about people in startups, so I will also understand what they are looking for and what they are doing, because developing or coding or doing all the business aspect of any startup is also very important. And I have immense respect about those fields. But at the same time, if we start applying service design or design thinking into all these projects, or if these people themselves start doing this, it's gonna make a really huge difference. Trust me, guys, it's gonna really make a huge difference. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for staying till the end. I know this podcast has been a roller coaster ride where we talk about why thinking is overrated, then why do I do a lot of stuff, how TED Talks help me, and now we are talking about this service design and the awareness about designing. I think you should get used to expecting diversity from this channel, because I have been pushing the motto of one channel and dynamic content, as I myself am not doing only one specific thing and I don't like to be in niche. That being said, thank you for listening to the Fun Indian Guy podcast, or thank you for watching the Fun Indian Guy podcast if you are on YouTube. Please do not forget to subscribe me on YouTube. Even if you are listening to my podcast on some other medium, go to YouTube and subscribe, because more subscribers we get, better we spread our vision, or better we spread our awareness. And there's a hell lot of things gonna come your way through this channel. So don't forget to have fun, because having fun is not an option, it's mandatory. Ciao, ciao.
The Fun Indian Guy Podcast.